When used as part of a quality floor finishing program, the highway straight edge is the key to making floors flatter. This video demonstrates how the tool is used, but for more detailed step-by-step procedures, you should refer to the booklet that came as part of this instructional package. Using a highway straight edge in place of a bull float increases floor flatness from 25 to 50%. On most projects, the tool can be used at three stages of the placement and finishing process. Generally, the more you use the straight edge, the better the flatness you get. The highway straight edge is a straight metal rectangular tube with a long handle attached at its midpoint. It's usually made of magnesium or aluminum. The tool got its name from its origin in road construction, and it goes by many other names as well. Some people call it a Cleveland, a bump cutter, check rod, a cross rod, or a scraping straight edge. While an ordinary straight edge rides on the side forms and is oriented more or less at right angles to them, the highway straight edge is independent of the forms and is oriented so that its blade is parallel with the forms. On conventional floors, the highway straight edge is typically used only for floating. Depending on the stiffness of the concrete surface, the highway straight edge can also be used for cutting and filling and for scraping. On super flat floors, it's often used for all three operations. The highway straight edge can also be used to work dry shakes into the concrete and to remove bleed water. The tool is offered in various configurations from different manufacturers. This is a new type of straight edge that allows the finisher to make sure that the straight edge is, in fact, straight before using it on the slab. A laser has been located inside the hollow blade. The absolutely straight line of light emitted by the laser is used to adjust the straight edge. A red indicator light means the blade needs adjustment. A green light indicates proper alignment. This and other highway straight edges come with an adjustable joint. The operator can change the blade's angle simply by twisting the handle. This feature makes the straight edge much easier to use and is almost essential when the handle is longer than 15 feet or so. When the concrete is wet, the highway straight edge can be used much like a bull float. The bottom of the blade should be almost horizontal, angled just enough to keep the leading edge from digging in. This floating operation usually takes place just minutes after concrete strike-off. If the concrete is poured at a very high slump, you may have to wait a few minutes for it to firm up enough to support the highway straight edge, but take care not to wait too long. As the concrete starts to set, the highway straight edge can be used to cut high spots and to fill low spots. Pull the blade across the concrete, stopping about 4 inches from the near edge of the slab. If your timing is right, and the blade is at the right angle, this step will remove mortar from the floor's high spots and leave it piled at the slab edge. The timing for cut and fill operations can only be determined by trial and error. If you try to do it too early, the straight edge will remove too much material. It will be all cut and no fill. But if you wait too long, the cutting will not yield enough material to fill the low spots. Another problem with waiting too long is that it may be hard to bond the fill material to the underlying concrete. Some contractors cut and fill the bumps left by the power float. This second method, power float first, then highway straight edge, is typical on super flat floors. After the concrete has set too hard for cutting and filling, it's still possible for a while to scrape down minor high spots. You can do this after power floating, and in some cases, even after the first or second trowel pass. Because scraping leaves the floor surface open, you'll usually need to trowel the concrete afterwards. Scraping is often done on superflat floors, but is rarely needed elsewhere. One basic rule of concrete finishing says never work the surface while bleed water is present. The danger is that the bleed water will be mixed with the surface mortar, making the floor surface weak just where it needs to be the strongest. Despite this rule, the highway straight edge can be used in bleed water. Instead of forcing the bleed water back into the slab, the highway straight edge pulls it off to the side where it does no harm. To remove bleed water, use the highway straight edge as a float. Make sure that each pass goes all the way to the edge of the slab, pushing the water completely off the fresh concrete. When a dry shake is applied in the traditional way with hand or power floats, it has a bad effect on floor flatness. But if the shake is applied with a highway straight edge, it's easier to make the floor flat. Procedures for finishing dry shake floors are described in another video in this series. In summary, the highway straight edge is most frequently used as a float, but it can also be used for cutting and filling, scraping, removing bleed water, and working dry shakes into the concrete. Using the highway straight edge is the single most important and the least expensive step that can be taken to improve the flatness of concrete floors.